And my uncle, they called him Ambrose, Brosie, they called him Bozy. My uncle Bozy was a hell of an athlete, they tell me, when he was a kid. And he became an Army Air Corps before the Air Force came along. He flew those single-engine planes as reconnaissance over war zones. And he got shot down in New Guinea. And they never found the body because there used to be a lot of cannibals for real in that part of New Guinea.
That was President Biden during a speech at the United Steelworkers Headquarters in Pittsburgh, where he suggested that his uncle, Ambrose Bozy Finnegan, who was a World War II veteran, was maybe, probably eaten by cannibals in New Guinea. However, the Pentagon says no, he probably was not eaten by cannibals. The Defense POW MIA accounting agency said, first of all, Finnegan's plane was not shot down in New Guinea. It was on its way to New Guinea when it went down for quote unquote unknown reasons. According to the DFAA, both of the plane's engines failed and the plane plunged into the ocean with only one of the four crew members surviving the crash. The three lost crew members were never found because they drowned in the ocean. So Peter Ducey questioned White House spokesperson Karine Jean-Pierre about Biden's account, and she seemed to struggle finding a response.
Second Lieutenant Ambrose J. Finnegan was a war hero, but the Pentagon says for unknown reasons, the plane was forced to ditch in the ocean. Both engines failed at low altitude. Why is President Biden saying he was shot down? There's no evidence of that. And why is he saying that his uncle was eaten by cannibals? That's a bad way to go.
He lost his life. It's not, look, I'm not, we should not make jokes about
it's
this.
Not, wait. President Biden said that his uncle was eaten by cannibals.
I mean, your last line is for a laugh. It's for a funny statement. And he takes this very seriously.
Yeah, it's understandable that she struggled because what do you say to something like that? Maz, what in the Occam's razor do you think of this?
I think it's hilarious. I mean, it's like, you know what you realize? These politicians, all of them should be encouraged to like stop talking. You know, like it'd be like, just hit the point and get out. Like he was telling the story of his uncle and he was a hero. You don't need to get specific, you know. Sometimes in life, less is more. Just be like, my uncle died, he was in World War II, he was a hero. And then if someone questions you, and by the way, if it's that outlandish in your mind that it was the cannibal situation, again, there's vague ways of being like, he died in a very unusual way. I'll let you know later. Like, I'm surprised after all these years they don't know how to avoid giving an answer or saying something that's gonna get them into this kind of hot water. But again, I mean, geez, he's old, he's Joe Biden, he rambles, these things come out. And you know, if you put him up face to face with Donald Trump, I feel like we have a lot of outlandish things that are said. Like just last week you had Donald Trump, he was somewhere in Pennsylvania and he was talking about Gettysburg and I think it was Robert E. Lee or something. And he goes, the General Lee was there and he goes, he told those soldiers, go up the hill, me boys. And he kept saying, go up the hill, me boys. And it was like, what are you talking about? And it's just goofy. So, you know, maybe this is his, Biden's response to go up the hill, me boys. He goes, my uncle was eaten by cannibals, me boys.
All right, Trump said something crazier in that same speech. He said that he had done more for black people than Lincoln did.
There you go.
More than freeing the slaves.
Yeah.
He's unbelievable, but yeah. They're both unbelievable, guys. So don't cut, you know, Karine Jean-Pierre falling on this. This is a serious issue. No, it's not.
Yeah.
No, he takes this very seriously. He didn't even know him. The guy died in World War II. What do you mean? She's making it sound like he died yesterday. Yeah. And he's like, no. Saying that your uncle was eaten by a cannibal is always funny. Okay. Especially because everyone knows there's no way your uncle was eaten by a cannibal.
Hilarious.
And that's the problem with Joe Biden. He's an old school embellisher.
Yeah.
He can't help but embellish a story. And he does it all the time. That's why the most surprising thing ever about Joe Biden was that corn pop was real. Like, I mean, he told that story about how he, you know, stood down this black gang member, which already sounds awful, by the way, right? And he wrapped a chain around his arm, and the corn pop had a razor and stuff. And everybody thought there's no way in the world that this story is true. And probably most of it wasn't anywhere near true. But it turns out there really was a corn pop. And that took so much heat off of him for all the other crazy stories he tells. Because people didn't want to get burned again, like, well, corn pop was real, you never know, right? No, but no, I knew. The minute this story started. First of all, the story's awesome because the guy's, his uncle's name is awesome. Ambrose Bozy Finnegan is the coolest name ever. It obviously comes out of a novel or a movie, right? And then he dies in World War II kind of heroically. His plane goes down in the ocean. Unfortunately, they don't find him. And of course, that's when the people of New Guinea dove into the ocean, found him in the bottom of the ocean, then started snacking on him. Come on, brother, come on. And so, I mean, but I'll flip it too. Look, if Trump had said this, come on, you know, we'd all be going nuts over it and saying he's like the craziest, dumbest son of a bitch there ever was, right?
Yeah.
So these are not great choices we've got.
Real quickly before Yasmin responds, I just think, how funny would it be since Soda Pop, what was it? Pop, what was his name? Pop.
Corn Pop.
Corn Pop. Yeah. Corn Pop came out. How funny would it be if some like person in Papua New Guinea came out and was like, my great grandfather ate the his uncle. You'd be like, oh my God, we have pictures.
But that would be from Corn Papua New Guinea.
There you go, Corn Papua New Guinea.
Man, it really does sound like a Hemingway novel or something like that. And you know, maybe I'm in the minority here, but I do like a little hyperbole if it makes the story better. I'll allow it. But my question is, like, did he live his whole life thinking his uncle was eaten by cannibals? Like, he's so old now. For the majority of his life, he thought that this is what happened, I guess. So.
Yeah, I don't know what Biden actually believes or not. See, that's the interesting part because, look, let's be honest, he's a little bit pathological too. Like, Trump is obviously brazenly pathological liar. Like, he just can't help himself at every turn, right? Like, if you put a mug in front of his face, but he thought he was gonna profit off of calling it a giraffe, he'd be like, this is obviously a giraffe. It's the nicest, most beautiful giraffe I've ever seen, right? You're like, brother, we have eyes, we can see it. We can see it, like he can't help himself. But Biden is a little bit pathological too, because I mean, the most outrageous lie in my opinion that he's ever told was that he got arrested with Nelson Mandela protesting apartheid in South Africa. Brother, did you not think that we would find out that you didn't get arrested with Nelson Mandela protesting apartheid? And by the way, he had a good story. He actually went to South Africa to against apartheid. There's no reason for him to embellish that story. But he can't help himself. And then but maybe the funniest of all is the three of us being surprised that these professional politicians are pathological liars. Come on, they're all liars, they're politicians.
I'm not surprised that they're liars. I see, like you said, you gotta do that to get to where you are. But I honestly think that Joe Biden believes that his uncle was eaten. I honestly feel that some family member was
like, he believed it.
I think so. The way he said it, he really got somber there for a minute. It's like, and then he was eaten by,
come on.
Because they had mustard, they used mustard back to, you know, a little ketchup. And
now look, guys, is it true in some islands, like a long, long time ago there was cannibalism? Yes. But the idea that, to me, that Maz, I don't know if it's worse that if he believes it, you see what I'm saying? Or if he doesn't believe, because I think if he believes it, it's slightly worse, because your whole life you never thought to ask your aunt or anyone else, you sure he was eaten by cannibals? And in the 1940s, his plane landed safely, but then they were devoured. And how do we know? Were there pictures? That never occurred to you to ask that, and you just took that as a given? So if he's being honest about it, I think it's slightly worse.
No, I agree with you, but as we know, you know, back in the day, and they're Irish, they're probably hitting the sauce. The aunt was probably hitting the sauce. She was probably a little drunk. She's like, come over here, Joseph. Your auntie wants to tell you a little story. The family didn't want you to know, but you're old enough to know now. Your uncle, whatever his name was eaten.
Bozy.
Uncle Bozy.
Remember Uncle Bozy? Yeah, he's not coming back.
I thought it felt like family folklore, and now in his old age, that's what comes out of his mouth at a campaign speech. So You know, I'm looking forward to the rest of the campaign if this is what he's already got.
Right?
Yeah, oh my God, imagine these two have a debate.
Oh, that's great.
Oh my God, so. Yeah. Well, I once tried to nuke a hurricane. That's Trump.
Okay. My uncle was eaten by Elmer Fudd. What? Uncle Bugs.
Yeah, totally. Oh, maybe he was the Tasmanian devil. Maybe he's from down there. Maybe he had a bite. Sounds a little bit more. Wait a minute. I'm so sorry. This is a very serious, somber issue about poor Uncle Bozy.
Rest in peace, Uncle Bozy.
That's right. And guys, I conclude by saying, this is the best America has to offer? Oh boy.
Yeah.
Yep, that's where we're at.